Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back to another card making video. Today I'm showcasing new products by Altenew. They have just came up with new white washi tapes and this video is actually part of a blog hop. Make sure to visit my blog, there are lots of giveaways along the hop and you will find tons of inspiration using the washi tapes. So first of all, I'm showing you here the gray tones or the black and white ones. I think that they are great just because they are really neutral and they work with pretty much any focal point, no matter the color. And although when you look at them, they don't make a great impact, they are perfect for subtle backgrounds. Now let's take a look at some other ones. This is quite subtle as well because the color is pink, but it has some golden splashes. And let's take a look at the rainbow ones. These are really fun to use. You can see they come in different sizes with stripes or with squares. And the fun part about this washi tape is that it can create a card as it is just by sticking it on your card base and stick on top a big sentiment. Now for today I will work with this one. I absolutely love it because if you take a close-up look you will see that it looks like concrete with foiled triangles on top. I find that it is really unique and unlike any other washi tape that I had in my stash. So I am sticking a piece of this washi tape on a white cardstock and I want this to be white at the background because the washi tape is semi-transparent and it's going to pick up some of the background color. I'm going to cut out the excess and I'm also going to use my paper trimmer and end up with a little piece. This is going to be my main background and I will go ahead and work on my focal points. For my flowers today, I will be working with the Flowering Cistus. This is a new stamp set by Altenew. There are matching dies that I will be working with today as well. And now you can work with any color for this card, but you will see that I'm going with white and gold just for a completely different look. Now this stamp set is a layering stamp set, so it gives you two flowers and every one of the flowers has four different layers. Just for a completely different look, I'm only going to stamp the third layer of each flower and I will also stamp the third layer of each leaf. Always remember there are more ways to use a stamp set than the expected one and that's what I'm going for today. You will see that I will stamp only the third layer and when I place on top the matching die, it's going to give the shape that I need and it's going to look like a flower. So I am placing everything down and I will ink up everything with embossing ink. This is by Altenew. I always like to ink up my stamps a couple of times. That's why I'm using a Misty, so that I know that I get a good impression, especially now that I cannot really tell where I have stamped. And then I'm going to apply on top embossing powder. I went with gold embossing powder by Altenew. This is actually rose gold. And now I'm going to use my heat gun and melt the embossing powder. And as you can probably tell, the shapes, the designs are not well defined just because they don't have an outside line. But this is not a problem. Once I use the dies on top, I will get the shape for the flowers and the leaves with no problem at all. And that's exactly what I'm doing here. I'm going to place the dies on top, secure them with some purple tape, run them through my die cutting machine, and here are all my die cuts. So here is another way to work with your layering stamps. Just stamp one of the layers and you see you get a beautiful design. Just another way to work with what you have and get completely different results. Now I'm working with a panel that has the washi tape and I'm going to stick that on a gold foiled cardstock. I just want to have two thin strips of gold on top and at the bottom of this strip and I could actually go more frugal instead of sticking that completely there, but you get the idea. Just having a very thin strip of gold on top and at the bottom. Now I'm going to stick that by using foam tape at the back on top of a pre-folded standard card that's 4¼ by 5½. And it seemed that my panel was just a hair bigger than my actual card, so I'm going to use my big scissors and turn that at the back just to trim off any excess. Now, all I have to do now is to create my flower composition at the top and at the sentiment. So I'm going to play a little bit with flowers and leaves and then stick them down. For some of them, I'm going with glue directly on top, so this is going to be completely flat. And for the main flower, I'm going with foam tape at the back to add dimension. This stamp set actually creates gorgeous flowers when you use all the layers. I just wanted to show you a completely different way, and this is a lovely technique and works with any other layering stamp that you have at home. Now I am also going to stamp a sentiment. The Flowering Cistus stamp set comes with many sentiments that you can use and that you can combine with the word you. So I went with the one that says happy birthday to, and I stamped that on a thin strip of white cardstock, which I'm just going to tuck underneath the flower. Then to complete your sentiment, you can either stamp one of the fonts that write you, so you end up having happy birthday to you, or you can use the matching dies. And in the matching die set, they give you two different fonts of you. I used one of them to cut it out from gold cardstock, and I'm going to stick it down. I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe only where the word you is going to touch the white cardstock. And now my card is pretty much ready. I'm going to add just a finishing touch at the center of my flower. I'm going to add a sequin. And this is from the new sequins by Altenew. And you can see here a close-up look on the card that I made for today. So shiny and really elegant. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Here are some close-up photos on the project that I made for today. Just like always, you will find links to everything I used down below in the description area. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.